Her and her family next door were asking about the closest position the servant to Allah is in the state of sujood. This is a hadith. It's not just a statement. It is a hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "أكثروا ما يكون العبد من ربه أقرب ما يكون العبد من ربه وهو ساجد." It is true. فأكثروا من الدعاء وأنتم سجود. So make lots of dua while you are in a state of sujood. Now, in another hadith, he said, أما الركوع فعظم فيه الرب. In a state of ركوع, you don't make dua. Rather, you glorify and magnify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying, سبحان ربي العظيم. And while in a state of sujood, فأكثروا فيه من الدعاء. Make a lot of dua in a state of sujood. That applies to the fard or to the nafl. Some people would say, when I say any dua, that even in your language, if you don't know Arabic, but if you're reciting supplications in the Quran, which were stated as verses, but meanwhile these supplications, the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam in Surah Ibrahim, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابِ. The dua of any prophet, the dua of Surah Al-Baqarah, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ, of Surah Al-Furqan, of Surah Al-Imran, when we recite them as means of invocation, that does not count as a recitation of the Qur'an. Why? Because it is prohibited to recite Qur'an in a state of ruku' and in a state of sujood. So there is no conflict here. When we recite it, I recite it with the intention of making dua. And that's why, if somebody is in a state of janaba, it is entirely prohibited for a male or a female in a state of janaba to recite the Qur'an, particularly the man where the janaba can be left in simply by performing ghusl. But if somebody is reciting this verse as a mean of dua, he's not reciting the entire verse, rather he's making dua, so it includes some of the verses of the Qur'an. That is valid and does not count as reciting the Qur'an.